Why did the Titanic's lights stay on, even as she slipped beneath the icy Atlantic? Of all the haunting details of that night in April 1912, one image stands out: a sinking ship, still aglow. Unlike the chaos we imagine in darkness, survivors recalled lit stairwells, glowing deck lamps, even electric bulbs shimmering beneath the rising water. The answer lies in an overlooked act of engineering and quiet heroism. This is the story of how a team of engineers gave their lives to keep the lights on, and why that mattered more than most people realize. Welcome back to Resonant Past, where forgotten innovations still shine today. The RMS Titanic wasn't just the largest ship afloat, it was also one of the most technologically advanced vessels of its time. Launched in 1912 by the White Star Line, the Titanic represented the cutting edge of early 20th century engineering. A floating city of steel, powered by steam and illuminated by electricity. She boasted over 10,000 electric light bulbs, from grand chandeliers in the dining saloon to lamps in steerage cabins. Her electric elevators, fans, and Marconi wireless system were all powered by a dedicated electrical plant located deep in the ship's belly. This wasn't some auxiliary setup. Titanic had four massive steam-powered generators, dynamos, each capable of producing 400 kilowatts of electricity. These were driven by their own steam engines, fed by coal from boilers shoveled by hand. In a time when many buildings on land still used gas lamps, Titanic's full electrification was remarkable. But electricity isn't magic, it has to be generated. And as the ship began to sink, keeping that power flowing became a battle of time, physics, and courage. Titanic's power plant was a marvel of redundancy and muscle. The ship's four dynamos supplied power not just to lighting, but to essential systems: communications, navigation, pumps, and safety equipment. Each dynamo was driven by a steam engine, with boilers located even lower in the ship. When the Titanic struck the iceberg at 11:40 p.m. on April 14, 1912, water began flooding the forward compartments almost immediately. The engines were stopped, and within minutes, the bow began to dip below the surface. Here's the key detail: while the engines were halted, the boilers feeding the dynamos were not. That meant that the Titanic's electrical system, including lights and wireless communications, continued to function. But only because someone kept feeding coal, and someone kept managing the dynamos, and someone, a team of over 30 engineers, electricians, and stokers, stayed behind to keep the plant alive. Among them was Chief Engineer Joseph Bell. He understood that without power, the ship would plunge into chaos. No lights, no wireless messages, no coordination for lifeboats. So Bell and his men stayed below deck, waist-deep in rising seawater, shoveling coal and managing pressure valves. Even as their escape routes were swallowed by the sea, they could have run. No one would have blamed them, but instead they stayed. For over an hour, as the Titanic listed and flooded, Joseph Bell and his team maintained power for the ship. It's believed they manually controlled valves to redirect steam away from the propulsion engines and toward the dynamos, maximizing the time the lights could remain on. Thanks to them, the wireless operators sent distress calls until the very end. Thanks to them, lifeboats were lowered in lit conditions. Thanks to them, staircases and passageways remained visible, allowing passengers to move more calmly. Witnesses on the RMS Carpathia, which rescued survivors, reported seeing Titanic's lights glowing until almost the moment she vanished. Bell and every member of his engineering crew died that night. Their sacrifice wasn't flashy. They weren't on the promenade deck. They weren't photographed. But their impact was enormous, because when everything else was going wrong, someone had to keep the lights on. Today, we remember the Titanic through movies, exhibits, and ghostly underwater footage. But one of the most poignant aspects of the disaster is often overlooked: the role of systems and the people who maintain them, even in crisis. Joseph Bell and his team weren't just brave. They were engineers who understood the stakes and used every second they had to support the evacuation effort. Without power, there would have been no wireless SOS. Without light, panic would have spread faster than the floodwater. Their actions shaped how we think about engineering ethics, redundancy, and crew training. And it reminds us of a deeper truth: that innovation isn't just about what we build, it's about how we choose to use it and who we rely on when it matters most. So the next time you hear that the lights stayed on aboard the Titanic, remember why. Not because the ship was unsinkable, but because the men who powered it were unshakable. In the darkest moments of history, sometimes the smallest lights shine brightest. Thanks for watching this episode of Resonant Past. If this story moved you, share it and subscribe for more stories where technology, bravery, and the human spirit intersect. Until next time, keep seeking the echoes of innovation and honoring the people behind them.